Hey, if you follow the channel, you'll see that I made this as, I called it a koi bowl, even though the colour was kind of wrong, where I wanted it to be that colour on the inside. Now, this one, I can assure you, is absolutely waterproof. This one that I'm going to make, which will be a replica of that, this kind of goes against, this goes against everything, doing what I'm about to do. But I'm going to make this one not waterproof. Now, as hard as it's going to be to do, it's not going to be hard to do or difficult to do, it's going to go against everything to make this full of pinholes, to recreate a bad job, let's just say a bad job that is going to leak. And then once we've demolded it, which may or may not be in this video, it depends how we get on for time, I'm going to show you how to properly repair fibreglass that's got pinholes in it. Okay, so I've got some glass cut, got the tools draining out. At the top here, I am going to need to do it properly because I need enough strength in this top to be able to demold it all the way out of here. So this will be the only proper bit. The rest of it will be a... It's going to hurt me to do it. It's going to hurt. But, you know, in the interest of science and technology and all that, and demonstrations of what can go wrong with fibreglass and why it goes wrong, this is a video to show you why it goes wrong. This is no word of a lie. I came off the phone to a DIY customer that I've helped do some consultancy services with to work out why his DIY job went bad. One of the reasons, he used roofing resin. Second reason, when he's used 5 litres or 5 kilos of resin, what he thought was 1%, which would have been 50 cc's of hardener, that stuff in the clear bottle I've just put in, he's put 5 cc's in. That will never fully kill dead fish. He's not used top coat. He's put black pigment into resin and used that as a top coat. Put some water in the pond, it's all gone discoloured. He wonders why. Getting in touch with me. Now, as I've said a million times before, this can be done DIY. If you get it wrong, which I am purposely going to do on here. One thing I see a lot of DIYers doing wrong is underestimating how much of that resin they're going to need. So I'm purposely going to put too little on. Purposely create a load of pinholes in it. Just like in that green job that was charged good money for. Back on my channel about 2 weeks ago. I've seen that job. Yeah. Get that on nice and dry. Just pull the camera in, Tracy, please, and just show them that dry glass look. See, it's still white. Mm-hmm. Okay. I get the feeling I could do this video without the commentary, yeah? And people would still, because you don't, these cameras can't show you the absolute detail, they'd still think, oh yeah, that's good fibreglass, isn't it? That's how you do it. Like I say, I've got to do that top bit properly because I need good leverage against the fibreglass, which I won't get with doing it weak. So let's put some dry glass on top of dry glass. Now, fibreglass, this is DIY style, yeah, that I do see a lot. To keep the imagined costs of the DIY kits down, they send them out a certain amount of stuff, and because they don't, the DIYer doesn't realise how much you need, they think, well, the supplier must have sent me the right amount of stuff. So when they start doing that, starts dwindling down, they're thinking, well, I've got to make this stretch now because it's enough. They wouldn't have sent me the wrong amount of stuff, surely. And then they start putting it on thin to make it last. Now, like I say, I've got to do this top bit solid. Some of this I'm actually doing right, you know, by tearing it to make it look a nice job. I just can't help doing it the way I do it, the right way, but this is ultimately going to be a very, very bad fiberglassing job. At the same time, I've got to make sure it demolds. We'll have plenty of fiberglass in the bottom, give it some stiffness. Gonna try and leave them spiky bits in that I saw in that green job. I mean, I don't mind this on this one occasion in my life. I don't mind making a purposely bad fiberglassing job, but leaving all them nasty things in it that I saw, no, that's just going too far for me. See, I'm even doing it right now by getting rid of these dry bits, which I'm not supposed to be doing. I'm meant to be leaving them in. I can't help but do it properly. Step back a bit, Tracy, because you might get some of it in there. We don't want that. This is another thing that DIYers get into, which is a right mess. Sorry, I know you're trying to get the close-up detail, but you don't want to get this on your nice frock.
Frock.
I mean, to do this really wrong, I should have picked a red hot day at 26 degrees. With the sun blazing down and done it in the sunshine. But it's a cloudy day, which is the right kind of day to do it if you're doing it without a cover on. Those days as a pro are few and far between, I'm afraid. We don't have that luxury. Going to say this once again, this can be done successfully DIY. Even someone like myself, very rarely, and I mean rarely, can have a bad job. You overlook something, you're distracted. It's how you respond to it as a pro, you know, to put it right. And I'm going to show you. Once we do demold this, I'm going to show you the right way to fix bad fiberglass. just got to get this top right because it won't, I won't be able to release it unless I do it properly. Use my very best roller for that. Let's leave that nasty in. Just pull the camera in there without getting gunged up. Let's leave that nasty in there. You see all this? We're going to leave all this in. We're going to leave all that dry glass in there. Look. And we are going to watch this piss water out all over the floor. We're going to leave those nasties in there. Those were seen in that green job that I fixed for someone the other day. This is more like it, you know, doing it properly. I've got to do it properly around the top. So I've got to get some wedges in there, and I need strength there. You don't get strength built in without using one of these tools. And there's your big clue. Great big clue. Yeah, let's leave all those nasties in there. It's hard to do it. Looking at that, knowing that it shouldn't be like that, it's hard to do, but I'm going to resist the temptation. I've already got the tool in my hand to do it and put it right, but I'm going to resist the temptation. But let's do this. Let's put some more resin on just to, yeah, that's the kind of thing they do. Some stuff. Yep, there you go. Got to be waterproof. Put some more resin on it, the state of it. Okay, let's come. Just pause that there, Tracy. I'll clean this tool up. Okay, so just to prove a point that putting an extra top coat on is not necessarily going to fill pinholes, right? I'm going to put a top coat on, say, half of the job. Hasn't been demolded yet, it's still in the mold, so let's just put the hardener in. Just not worry about percentages. Let's not worry about what it looks like. Oh, this is hard. This is hard to do. Dry glass, pinholes. Not rolled properly, not knocked down properly, not wet out properly, all left jagged and sticking up. Extreme example of bad fiberglass, and this is extreme. And when I'm honest enough to say, yeah, I might make a mistake once every few years on a job, yeah? It ain't these kind of mistakes. Not this awful. So let's just do. Say half. And then what we'll do, we'll take a photograph as if it's going on the internet. Take a photograph from over there. Hey, look, yeah, I've fiberglassed my pond. It'll look great from over there. It'll look great from outer space. Now I'm doing it properly by going over it multiple times. I don't want to do. So let's see which half leaks. That one, are we halfway? Let's go over them pinholes. There. Let's mark up where them pinholes most definitely are. Yeah. Have a look in there.
Nice.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Quality workmanship.
Quality British craftsmanship. Let's put some on thin as well. Look. And then just go and have a walk over there and film it from over there as if it's going on Facebook. How good it looks. Looks brilliant from over there, doesn't it?
Ain't wrong with that.
There's some good glasses out there. Use them. Yeah, that's beautiful, that. Shuffed a bit to that. Champion, isn't it?
Good job, well done.
So the fish will just swim around these snots and nasties.
You just see that one there?
Tracy, I kid you not, I was grinding stuff off this like on a job that a customer paid someone for. Just a week ago. Not even joking, I've got video. The video evidence speaks for itself. So, that's how you do a very, very bad fiberglassing job. Nice frock, mate. Yeah, very bad, very badly done indeed. So we'll get this warmed up, cooled down, demolded, and then we'll put some water in it to show you what happens to bad fiberglass. Okay, so as you've just seen, that is some very, very nastily, badly done fiberglassing. There's no way that's going to hold water, even where there's top coat on it. But, well, this is basically a wedge. Put it in between the fiberglass, which I reinforced and did properly at the top. You wedge it between that and the plastic tub and it will prise it out and lift it up, but it's got to go cold yet. It's still hot. This is still hot to the touch because of the excessive amount of hardener I put in here. It was ridiculous. So rather than wait for this to cool down, set rock hard, I'm literally going to leave this overnight. We'll call this part one, and then part two will be tomorrow when I'm back at the yard loading up for a job on Monday in Gloucester, where I should be using a new bit of kit. It's all my glass rolling bit of kit. I'll spray paint this up here tomorrow as well, get that looking nice and tidy, and we'll come back to this, we'll revisit this, we'll demold it. I was going to say fill it with water, but it won't hold water, and then very possibly tomorrow. Well, put it this way, if this was a production unit, a production item made in a factory, whether it be one a day, four or five of them a day out of the same mold, this would be condemned. It would be thrown in the bin and be just be called a scrap unit. Total waste. It would be cut up and disposed of because it wouldn't be worth the time in repairing it. But let's say this is 40 square meters on a koi pond and ripping it all out is just going to be catastrophically an expensive thing to do. But sometimes those things have to be done because it is that, you know, the DIY jobs go that catastrophically wrong. So tomorrow I will show you on this extreme example. Don't forget, this is an extreme example of bad fiberglassing, how to put things like this all right. You'll be surprised how it's done. It ain't done by putting an extra top coat on it. That's not good enough. Right, part one done, part two tomorrow.